To map the potential between two electrodes, I'm going to define a potential between the two electrodes with the Hampden power supply, which is plugged into the gold outlet under the table. I'll use one alligator clip to banana plug and connect to one of the silver paint electrodes with a push pin on my conductive paper. I'll use the other banana plug to alligator clip to connect to my other electrode, taking care to try and keep the wires as much off the paper as possible because they can influence the field and potential. I'll then turn on the Hampden and slowly dial it up to 10 volts, and I'm on the DC side. So I've said the potential difference between those two places is 10 volts. I'll use our Keithley multimeter, turn it on. It's plugged into the silver outlets, and I'll use two banana to banana plugs there, making sure that I'm in the front section, I'm in DC volts, and I'm going to set the range with the up range button to 10 volts. I'll measure from low and put that low in the low from the Hampden. And then high. So now the Keithley measures a potential difference, the voltage difference between this point and this point. If I connect those two points together, I get 0 volts. If I connect to this point, I'll see, oh, I've got slightly over 10 volts. Let me dial that down until I get 10 volts. Not too far. Volts between this point and this point being electrically connected down there. Now, I can find lines of equal potential everywhere along here, should be an equal potential. That's an easy one. And then I'm going to find another one. So I'll look for a point where the potential is 8 volts, moving my probe around until I find 8 volts to within 8.0, and then I would mark that point, or have a lab partner mark that point on my sheet, drawing my electrodes on the plotting paper so that I have that as a reference. I would then look for another distant point, also at 8 volts, moving the probe, gently pressing into the paper until I find another one. Then I'll find another point at 8 volts. I want to get about 7 points all at 8 volts so that I have a sense of the shape of a line that would connect all of those points, or a curve that would connect all of those points. Then I would look for a 6 volt point, moving my probe around until I find 6 volts. So I'm measuring the potential difference between this point and this point as currently 6.02 volts, and then I would find another one. Finding equipotential lines for 8 volts, 6 volts, 4 volts, and 2 volts, getting about 7 points on each of those lines, those equipotential lines, so that I can define the curves that make up those equipotentials.